At Mario's baptism, the church welcomed him into the church and into the family of God. Please join in singing our opening hymn found on the inside cover of your worship aids, Te Alabamos, Señor, as we welcome him and his family this day. Please stand. Before we continue our celebration, as I mentioned, we need to look at this as a celebration. Obviously, it's one that is filled with hurt and pain and suffering as we say goodbye to someone so young. But yet with people with eyes of faith, we look to God as a celebration, praying that our Lord, who triumphed over sin and death, is now welcoming our brother Mario home to him in that eternal life. And so as we gather here, we recognize at the very beginning of our celebration how he was brought into the life of Christ at the very moments of his baptism. In a few moments, I'll be sprinkling the casket with holy water, reminding us of the baptismal waters that welcomed him into the church and into the family of God. And at the same time, we pray that our Lord, as we hear in our psalm, the Good Shepherd, is now welcoming Mario into the restful waters of heaven. And then we'll place the pall over the casket as a reminder of the baptismal garment that he placed, that was placed on him, where he put on the life of Christ. The whiteness of cloth symbolizes the purity and the love of God that God calls all of us to, and God enfolds all of us in as well. And then finally, here at the foot of the sanctuary, we have the Easter candle, the Paschal candle, reminding us of the baptismal candle that Mario received, as well as his parents and godparents at his baptism, where they were called to receive the light of Christ and called to share that light of Christ with those around them. And so likewise, we pray that God will help us that even in this time of darkness and pain, Christ and his light continues to shine. And so as we do so, we do it in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you and with your spirit. In the waters of baptism, Mario died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. May Christ, who claimed Mario in baptism, now enfold him in his love and bring him to eternal life. Let us pray. Lord our God, the death of our brother Mario recalls our human condition and the brevity of our lives on earth. But for those who believe in your love, death is not the end, nor does it destroy the bonds that you forge in our lives. We share the faith of your Son's disciples and the hope of the children of God. Bring the light of Christ's resurrection to this time of testing and pain as we pray for Mario and those who love him through Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you please be seated now as we listen to our Lord in the scriptures.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give a gift from the springs of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Our responsorial psalm is "Shepherd Me, O God," number 480 in the music issue. I will sing the verses and I ask you to join me on the refrain.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Gently you raise me and heal my weary soul. You lead me by pathways of righteousness and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Though I should wander I fear no evil, for you are at my side. Your rod and your staff, my comfort and my hope. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Surely your kindness and mercy follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of my God forevermore. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that he may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has yet been revealed. We do not know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus answered, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. During the Holy Triduum, which is Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Holy Saturday, as I was preparing my homily for one of the masses or service, I came across a song from Casting Crowns called Just Beheld. I liked the lyrics of that song and thought it would be a good song perhaps for a distant funeral. Little did I know that I would be using it in a couple of weeks later for this funeral today, so soon, for someone so young, for the loss of a loved one so great. When I looked up the history of the song, I read that it was created a year and a half before the writer of the song, Mark Hall, was diagnosed with cancer on his kidney. Just like how I heard the song 2 weeks before I was actually going to use it here in a few moments, Mark wrote that not knowing that the message of that song was going to apply him and his own struggle with cancer a year or so later. Mark said, God gave me this song a year and a half before I got cancer because he knew I was going to need it. It was a cool moment for me, Mark said. Well, my brothers and sisters, I pray that the message that you will be soon hearing in a few moments from that song will help you in your time of need, and that it will be also a cool moment for you as well. And not only do I pray that the lyrics will help during this difficult time, but more so, I pray that the scriptures that we just heard, these readings, that they also will have that same impact as well. Take, for example, our first reading from the book of Revelation. As St. John writes his vision, he sees the former heaven and former earth passing away and the sea no more. Jesus, who now dwells with the human race, became one like us in our humanity and has gone to the cross for us and has made all things new. A new heaven and earth, a holy city, a new Jerusalem has come down out of heaven from God and dwelt among us and now is ushering forward the kingdom of God. God has given us hope that something good can come out of something bad, something new, like we are not alone in our suffering and that God is with us, can overcome the feeling of anger and abandonment, suffering and pain. Like this reading from the book of Revelation, this song describes any person's journey through tough times in their life and feeling as if the answers are perhaps so far away. The person may feel like they can't go on anymore and that they don't know where to turn to or how to turn to God. And maybe that's something that you're feeling this day. In that first verse of the song, it writes, "Hold it all together. Everybody needs you strong. But life hits you out of nowhere and barely leaves you holding on. And when you're tired of fighting, chained by your control, there's freedom in surrender. Lay it down and let it go." Then the chorus goes on. "So when you're on your knees and answers seem so far away, you're not alone. Stop holding on and just be held. Your world's not falling apart. It's falling into place. I'm on the throne. Stop holding on and just be held. Just be held. Just be held." The song suggests to us to just let go of everything that we have been holding on to and just be held by God himself. It reminds us that we are not alone and that no matter what we are going through, our world may feel like it's falling apart around us, but in all reality, it is actually falling into the exact place that it is supposed to. It's all God's timing, and it needs all to be placed in his loving hands. We do not have to keep holding on to the things that are causing us more harm and pain than good. We do not have to keep a strong hold of things such as the pain of losing a loved one like Mario, or how he died so young, or the feelings of wanting to blame ourselves or blame someone else, but instead place all of this into the loving hands of God. Rather, let us hold on to the good things, like the memories of his infectious smile and always being happy and his passion for soccer, memories of his love for our country and being a part of the National Guard, which I was told that he loved the National Guard, And he would go to drills even though there were times that he didn't have to. He loved it that much. Hold on to the memories of his hard work ethic and how he had such a wonderful impact on our school here at Redwood. Hold on to the memories of how he loved and adored you, his family, his friends, his classmates, fellow guardsmen, and how he brought you joy and laughter. And as you hold on to these memories, why not also exemplify them in your own lives? Why not affect others with a smile or with a positive attitude? Why not consider serving your country through the military, or perhaps at least making your voice heard to our politicians and pray for them, and praying for our service men and women, those who are here today, and thank you for your service, and those who are out on the front lines fighting for our freedom? Why not love our family, our friends, and even our enemies, and adore them as if we are loving and adoring our Lord himself? Why not have a hard work ethic, making an impact on our school, our community, and our churches? Because like St. John wrote in his first letter in our second reading, when we do love, we are actually revealing God's great love for us. We are actually making himself known and are keeping our eyes fixed on him, which now brings me to the second verse of that song. If your eyes are on the storm, you'll wonder if I love you still. But if your eyes are on the cross, you'll know I always have, and I always will. And not a tear is wasted. In time, you'll understand. I'm painting beauty with the ashes. Your life is in my hands. That second verse reminds us to keep our eyes focused on things above and to keep our eyes focused on God through any storm that we may face in this life. Because if our eyes are on the storms of life, we will begin to wonder if God still loves us, or if he loves us at all. But if our eyes stay on the cross, stay on Christ himself, we will realize that he always has loved us and always will love us, no matter what. Sometimes it may not seem as though God is there or that he cares even remotely, but the exact opposite is true. God loved us enough that he was willing to die for us. If we focus on the bad things in our lives constantly, we will definitely lose sight of the goodness that he brings to our lives every day. That yes, we sometimes have to face Calvary in order to experience the empty tomb of Easter. We just have to keep our eyes tuned into the things that he is telling us, showing us, and teaching us day by day. If our eyes on him throughout our lives, we will feel more peace and we will begin to know him more and we'll actually feel his presence and his peace, even when the storms rage. No tear is wasted, as we heard in that song, for God knows what is supposed to happen and how frustrating our lives can sometimes be. He understands the pain that we go through individually. He cares about each of us in his special way. He knows how to make a rainbow out of a storm. Remember, don't tell God how big your storm is. Tell the storm how big your God is. He can and is literally painting a beautiful picture of each of our lives, even through the pain that we face. We don't see the big picture because he is God and we are mere human. But one day he will give us the privilege to know exactly why he had specific plans for our lives. And then we will see those things that we suffered in this life indeed had a place. The final verse writes, lift your hands, lift your eyes, and the storm is where you'll find me. And where you are, I'll hold your heart. I'll hold your heart. Come to me, find your rest in the arms of the God who won't let go. This says that we have the privilege to take God at any time, day or night. If we feel lost, we can easily cry out to him by lifting up our hands, our voices, and our hearts to him. It's okay to ask God why things happen the way they do, especially when we don't understand why or how things are happening, or when you're unsure of how to handle them. But just remember, like the song, or like Jesus in our gospel from St. Matthew, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. If our Lord allows us to place our burdens before him and on him at any time, we should actually take him up on it. He allows us every chance to find peace, to take him at his word that he will provide for you, even in your times of suffering and pain. No matter what language we speak, what culture we come from, God is always listening and there for us. In mi homilia, estuvo explicando la canción, just be held, o solo ser retenido. Con la muerte de nuestro hermano Mario, solos nos dejó recuerdos. Recemos por su alma, que la alegría y el amor que compartió con sus familiares y amigos, y por su dedicación de servir a su país, no sirvan de ejemplos para nosotros a seguir, como nos recuerdan las lecturas de hoy. Dios de no quiere que nos quedemos en el dolor y en el sufrimiento. Dios quiere que confiemos en él porque el Dios es la vida y la felicidad eterna. Mis oraciones y condolencias a la familia de Mario. Therefore, as we strive to reveal God's love by modeling the joy and love that Mario portrayed, let us continue to pray that our brother Mario is now being loved and held in the loving arms of God. However, let us also place ourselves into that same loving arms as well, with our brokenness, our woundedness, our very lives. God is and will always be there for us. Remember, when you're on your knees and answers seem so far away, you're not alone. Stop holding on. Stop holding on to the things that we cannot control and just be held. Your world's not falling apart. It's actually falling into place, God's place. Remember, we are not on the throne, God is. Stop holding on and just be held. Just be held. Just be held. And I guarantee it will be a cool moment for all of us.
Hold it all together, everybody needs you strong. But life hits you out of nowhere and barely leaves you holding on. And when you're tired of fighting, chained by your control, there's freedom in surrender. Lay it down and let it go. So when you're on your knees and answers seem so far away, you're not alone, stop holding on and just be held. Your world's not falling apart, it's falling into place. I'm on the throne, stop holding on and just be held. Just be held. Just be held. Your eyes are on the storm, you wonder if I love you still. But if your eyes are on the cross, you know I always have and I always will. Then not a tear is wasted, in time you'll understand. I'm painting beauty with the ashes, your life is in my hands. So when you're on your knees and answers seem so far away, you're not alone, stop holding on and just be held. Your world's not falling apart, it's falling into place. I'm on the throne, stop holding on and just be held. Just be held. Just be held. Lift your hands, lift your eyes. is where you'll find me. And where you are, I'll hold your heart. I'll hold your heart. Come to me, find your rest in the arms of the God who won't let go. So when you're on your knees and answer seems so far away, you're not alone, stop holding on and just be him. Your world's not falling apart, it's falling into place. I'm on the throne, stop holding on and just be just be held.
And so as we pray that our brother Mario now is in the hands being held by our God, let us also place in those same loving arms our prayers and our petitions as well. And to each of these prayers, please respond, Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who preach the gospel may be given the strength to express in action the word they proclaim. We pray to the Lord. That those in public office may promote justice and peace. We pray to the Lord. That those who bear the cross of pain in mind and body may never feel forsaken by God. We pray to the Lord. That God may deliver the soul of his servant Mario from punishment and from the powers of darkness. We pray to the Lord. That God, in his mercy, may blot out all his offenses. We pray to the Lord. That God may establish him in light and peace. We pray to the Lord. That God may call him to happiness in the company of all the saints, we pray to the Lord. That God may welcome him into his glory, those of our family and friends who have departed this life, we pray to the Lord. That those who are in the military, may they be strengthened and safeguarded as they work to protect and keep our country safe. We pray to the Lord. That God may give a place in the kingdom of heaven to all the faithfully departed. We pray to the Lord.
God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of Mario and all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May you please be seated now as we prepare the altar and bring forth our offerings.
Hands in obeas, gabian tu rebanio. Hands in obeas. la cor con tus hombros, yo redivivo. Es tan gran contoria, vuelvo en arrepentirse. Toda vilubias, pero abundas más, con el amor. Vagando en el mundo, sin Dios y sin luz. Pero todavía existen pastores que por la montaña a buscar la cuando las hayan, no trinco camino, al camino bueno, la verdad y vida, que es Cristo el Señor.
Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The sacrifice at your hands. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Mario may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying may be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Invite you to please kneel, or you may be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Catherine, Saint Mark, Saint Pius, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Chad, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Mario, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of Christ's peace. Again, I invite you to please kneel, or you may be seated. For the communion rite, for those Catholics who are able to receive our Lord in Holy Communion, we'll have two stations offering the body of Christ, one on either side of Mario, offering the precious blood, one on either side on the outside of the sanctuary. For those of you who share other faith traditions or are unable to receive our Lord in Holy Communion, if you just want to indicate to one of the ministers or myself that you prefer a blessing, by just folding your arms across your chest like this. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For our communion meditation, we sing Pan de Vida, number 360 in the music issue.
Amor.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Mario, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Just a couple of announcements. One is please join us over at the Rademacher Hall, which is through these sets of doors into our gatherings, our social hall, where we will have a luncheon that has been prepared for all of you. So feel free to join us for that luncheon. However, before we go over there, we're going to be processing out outside of the church here, where we're going to have our military honors for our brother. And then we invite you to come then and join us over at the hall again for some lunch and for some fellowship. Then we'll have Mario's rite of committal done at a later date. So if you can keep him and keep one another in prayer as well. Thanks to all who helped out with the various ministries, from music to reading, sharing our Lord in Holy Communion, bringing forward the gifts, helping with serving, to all pallbearers, to our National Guardsmen for your wonderful witness to your presence, your service to our country. And is it Jared, right? Jared, Sergeant, First Class, or something. I know there's a whole bunch of titles that you guys have. It's kind of cool. But anyways, what I thought was even neater was that yesterday afternoon, Jared was there from the moment that I got there around 3 o'clock or right before 3 o'clock, and I'm sure you were before that. He was all there all the way to last night. He was here this morning, and what I see that is just a wonderful witness of our country. And again, our men and women who have risked their lives for our freedom, our safety, but that support that you have for one another as well, till your final breath. Just being that wonderful presence to the family says so much, and so thank you for being that wonderful presence. It just reminded me that's what God does with us, that no matter how what's going on in our lives, no matter how dark our lives are, God is right there with us every step of the way. He wants to hold on to us. We just have to let go and let him. And so again, please join us now after our procession out, our military honors, then for our lunch and fellowship here now afterwards. But before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And so I invite you to take a few moments now in silent prayer as we pray for our brother. In Psalm 141, it writes, our prayers rise like incense, our hands like an evening offering. As we lift our prayers now to our Lord like the smoke of the incense, please join in singing our song of farewell, which is also found in your music issue, number 833, as we sing, as we say goodbye to our brother.
Come to his aid, O Savior.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Mario, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Mario, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. And as we'll have the committal at a later date, we'll do the blessing and the dismissal here now. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God. In peace, let us take our brother to his final place of rest. And as we do so, please join in singing our closing hymn on the backside of your worship aid, Para Amar Como Tú.
Oh God, great is your love, everlasting and true. To feed the hungry, your marco motu. To welcome the stranger, your marco motu. Oh God, great is your love. Everlasting and true, Señor, danos tu amor, para amar como tú. To call the naked, llamar como tú. To bring your forgiveness, llamar como tú. Oh God, great is your love, everlasting and true. Señor, danos tu amor, para amar como tú. To love our neighbor, llamar como tú. To shelter the homeless, llamar como tú. Oh God, great is your love, everlasting and true. Señor, danos tu amor, para amar como tú. To work for justice, llamar como tú. To ransom the captive, llamar como tú. Oh God, great is your love, everlasting and true. Señor, danos tu amor, para amar como tú.